30 seconds left in regulation time. Seidenberg in his own zone. On the wing, Jokinen. This way, it's Joni Pikkanen. Here he comes. Pikkanen going wide, shooting one off the stick of Brodeur. Jokinen now feeds it this way. Joni Pikkanen again for Carolina. Moving by Martin. Inside for Jussi Jokinen. Jokinen steams away from Madden. Holding onto it. Jussi Jokinen paddled down for Brodeur. Out of the corner now, Martin played along the boards. Pikkanen settles it down. One-timer, Seidenberg.
Is the supervisor, as will Toronto be involved and hit a skate on the way, and that's not the issue. Had time expired. The Devils have stayed on the ice and on the bench. Carolina, you thought they needed an intermission based on the way things went. It's the Devils that needed the intermission. What an absolute relentless assault. And it doesn't matter, we need to get a clock on the monitor here. That is the issue. It's nothing other than that. Obviously off the left skate of Jokinen, but that doesn't matter. There is a delayed reaction, and it's a slight one, and this is anything but scientific. They won't go on that upstairs and in Toronto.
That's two different horns. That's the goal horn, you know what I mean? The other horn you couldn't hear. And it is a goal. It beat the horn by 0.2 seconds. 0.2 seconds. Carolina wins it in regulation, 4-3.
John, first of all, the Canes won't worry about, as they say in golf, how but how many. We had the Molson Miracle in 2002 that you and I had the distinction of calling. We've just had the RBC Center Miracle. And look at the disgust from Brodeur. And I'll tell you what, John. Oh, look at that. That's not good right there. I don't care if you're the winningest goaltender of all time. That is not acceptable. I'm not even going to say understandable. But the Carolina Hurricanes, and I give full marks to Eric Staal. Eric Staal turned this game. He turned the game after it went 3-3. Paul Maurice used Jokinen and company. Late in the game, a line that had not been together for a while, Jokinen and Samsonov and Brind'Amour. There is absolutely nothing that's outside the crease, and I would even argue that Marty Brodeur tried to initiate the contact, not let it come after him. And the left skate of Jussi Jokinen perhaps was blessed by our good buddy Nick Vallin. And Jussi Jokinen has a playoff overtime goal in what would have been, I think you and I agree, my dear partner, a disaster.
Well, you saw it out in front, and it counts, and it comes with 0.2 seconds left in regulation time. A miraculous finish here in Raleigh. Carolina has evened the best of seven series at 2 games apiece.
One other thing, John, and I'm really surprised because Marty Brodeur is the winningest goalie in the history of the league for so many reasons. One of them is that he's a phenomenal human being. And just to educate, goaltender interference, if there is inadvertent contact within the crease, it can be called. That fine look from our truck showed not only was it well out of the crease, but he's the one that went looking for it. So there's no argument. The proper due justice was done upstairs to make sure time was left on the clock. And what a cardiac telecast.
That'll do it. Carolina gets it done here in the fourth game in one of the greatest games ever played. And there have been many in playoff history here at the RBC Center. Next game will be Thursday night from The Rock in Newark. Game number 5, Hurricanes Live, coming your way right after this timeout.